I live real close to downtown Tijuana, right? And I go there, you know, just to take walks and look around. They have a lot of, you know, art stuff and, you know, a lot of little shops. And I seen this guy with Brody, and he was selling them. And I, you know, my friend has a female like Brody, female French bulldog. And you know, I asked him. I said, "Hey, what are you doing with the pup?" And he said, "Oh, I'm selling it." I said, "Oh, okay." And I called my friend and I told him, "Hey, there's a guy over here that has a male. Would you mind if I buy it? Would you mind if we make some puppies and, you know, try to make a little bit of money? We're, you know, life is hard out here in Tijuana." And he said, "Yeah," he didn't mind. So I went in and bought the dog. I gave him my savings, and man, it was just crazy. I showed my brother the dog, and he had told me, "Hey, that dog looks like one that's lost out here." And I said, let me see. And he sent me he sent me a screenshot of the missing dog. And I thought about it for a day. And, you know, the dog did look a little sad and depressed. You know, I said, "Man, let me call him. Let me see if this is the one." You know, there was a little doubt in my mind. I was, you know, thinking, well, that's like really far from home. So, you know, I called and it was him. It was Brody. So when I called the owner, he asked me, "Does he have a tattoo on his?" I guess he has like a serial number. I don't know what it is. He said, "There's a tattoo on the back of his leg. Can you check and see if he has it?" And I did. I checked. I took a picture of it. And I sent it to him, and he said, "Yeah, that's him." I said, "Well, he's right here. If you guys," I told him, "I'm deported. I can't go back. So, I can't cross, but I can have my girlfriend take him to San Diego, and you can meet her over there so that you can get your dog back." And he said, "Yeah, that was fine." And within the next day, he was already here. You know, just having him here at my house and just, you know, looking at how he was acting, and he was, you know, real sad. You know, I can relate to him. You know, he's out here, no family. I'm out here, no family. You know, if he can go back, I just wanted to take him back home. That's all. I was born in Mexico, and, you know, and when I was a kid, when I was a baby, they brought me to the United States, and I grew up in the United States my whole life. I'm from Oakland, California, and you know, I did a lot of prison time, and I got deported right after that. After getting out, I came to a foreign country. Basically, I had never been to Mexico. And here I am. All my family, my brothers, sisters, cousins, aunties, everyone is on the other side. As a young Mexican kid, I just, you know, we always, you know, I took the wrong path. I made mistakes, and, you know, I'm paying for my mistakes now. I went to prison as a young kid and got out a grown man, and it's just, I never had the experience to live by myself. I never, you know, I was still living with my mom when this happened. And, you know, it's hard. It's really hard. And sometimes I want to go back, but I can't go back. It's just, it's the mind.